generally what in this, the second and third quarters were obviously huge quarters for you guys. What did you think turned it there? What happened in those two quarters?
I thought we just played simple basketball, kept our turnovers down, moved the ball. Our guys were playing with a lot of force, a lot of aggressiveness, but making good decisions within that aggression. And that's the key. Can you find that balance? Can you play with pace and confidence and yet make really simple decisions, hit singles and just move the ball? I thought Steph was brilliant, you know, in the first half he wasn't really going like offensively, but he was just running our team and Klay got it going, and our defense was, you know, kind of fueling our offense, and we connected the game really well.
Coach, obviously, Klay Thompson was spectacular tonight.
Where am I looking?
Right here.
Oh, sorry.
No, you're good. But JaMychal Green, he seemed to have been one of the adjustments made from game one to game two. And, I mean, 15 points, 12 minutes, 50% from three. It seemed that he helped spacing on the floor. You know, what would you say about the fact that you decided to go with him in the starting lineup and then later and how much he helped you guys tonight?
Well, number one, I'm just proud of J. Mike. It's been a tough year for him, you know, for a lot of reasons. You know, he missed some time with a few different ailments. And then when he was healthy, you know, he was out of the rotation. I didn't play him a whole lot, and he just stayed ready, and he took advantage of his opportunity, and this seemed like a series for him, just with the way the Lakers are playing us defensively, and I couldn't be happier for J. Mike. He's really earned this by just staying positive and staying ready.
Steve, what did you think of Draymond's defense, particularly on Anthony Davis, especially as you guys went to that small?
Yeah, Draymond was brilliant. I mean, you know, this is the guy who, you know, we have to have. You know, he's our engine, and we decided to, you know, to put him on Davis tonight from the start. And I thought he got us off to a good start defensively, just with his aggressiveness.
And we talked a lot about the free throw discrepancy after last game. I mean, the Lakers took like more than 10 less. You guys took about 10 more, I think.
Yeah.
What did you see from your aggressiveness, assertiveness that you guys were focusing on after game one?
Yeah, we did a better job of defending without fouling and staying aggressive. I'm sitting here looking at the game one box score right here. So this says they outscored us 29-6 from the foul line. So Raymond Ritter clearly did not put the right box score next to the podium. So, you know, do you have it? Do you have game two? Okay, thank you. Yeah, it's good. It's good to have someone competent who can get the right box score next to me. Thank you,
Steve over here on you. On your right, you've often referred to Klay's 37-point quarter as a religious experience. When he goes off like he does in the third and he hops around like game six Klay, what is that kind of experience like?
Well, that's the best version of Klay, you know, when he's really going offensively, but he's taking great shots. And that's what I liked about tonight. I just thought we got really good shots, you know, 21 for 42 from three. Obviously a great percentage, but I think the percentage was a reflection of the clean looks we were getting and the fact that the guys weren't forcing anything. They were just – the ball was moving. They were just moving it to the open guy, and Klay obviously can get really hot, really fast, and it's more likely to happen when we're moving the ball like we did tonight.
Steve, to clarify – could Looney have started? Was he okay to start? And also, could you take us a little bit more inside the decision?
So, yeah, so what happened was literally 2 hours before game time, Loon came down pretty ill. And so I talked to Rick Celebrini, and he said that Loon probably won't be able to play more than 20 minutes or so, given his illness. It's tough to play a guy 20 minutes when you start him, because then he ends up sitting forever, and there's kind of some awkward, lengthy periods on the bench, and it's hard to find a rhythm. So we decided to bring him off the bench, and that would help his rhythm a little bit more, and we could limit his minutes. And we knew we were going to play JaMychal anyway, like we did in game one. So we just decided to start JaMychal and get the floor spacing that he offers. And J. Mike was great. You know, he knocked down some threes, and, you know, he's aggressive and athletic and obviously played a great game.
Hey, Steve, over here. Following up on Draymond, after game one, he said that he was disgusted with the way he played. Did you sense a difference in energy tonight with him, especially the way that was able to permeate to the rest of the team?
Yeah, for sure. I mean, anytime we lose and Draymond has a game that is disappointing for him, where he doesn't think he's played his best, you know how he's going to respond. He's the ultimate competitor. And he came out tonight and he was aggressive from the beginning. I loved his game at both ends. He rebounded, he defended, he got the ball moving. So Draymond was brilliant.
Hey, Steve, another byproduct of Klay's big night, you got to rest everybody in the fourth quarter. The series is every other day. How big is that, just being able to rest your veterans?
Yeah, I mean, we didn't play anybody more than, I think Klay played 31 minutes. That was, it was tops on the team, so it's good for us to not have anybody else over 30 and keep Klay at 31. And, given the nature of the game, they were able to do the same thing, resting their guys in the fourth. I think, both teams should benefit from that going into game three.
I think you started Klay on defense on D'Angelo. Was that correct?
Yes.
And was that – do you think that got him in the game maybe a little? Sometimes you said that, if you get Klay on somebody and it kind of gets him mentally into the game.
Klay is capable of guarding pretty much anybody, not centers, but 1 through 4 he can guard. And he really likes guarding the ball. I think that's his best defensive attribute. And so he did a nice job, right away, just getting into the ball and taking on that challenge of D'Lo. Everything seemed to click tonight and went our way. But you never know how game three is going to go. So we've got to be ready for whatever comes our way.
And just given their lineup, did you sense that this Klay might be a guy to be able to spring loose in this series? Just they don't have an overwhelming amount of wing defenders over there.
I mean, Klay can always get going. It doesn't matter how many wing defenders the opponent has. Klay is always capable of getting loose. I think the key, again, we had 38 assists, so the key for us tonight was getting the movement, getting the flow, and just continuing to hit singles and not try to force anything. And so Klay, when we do that, Klay tends to get really clean looks, and that's what happened tonight.
Steve, the last time you won a playoff game, Steph took 38 shots and scored 50. Tonight he takes 12, and you got contributions up and down the lineup. Which one do you prefer more? Like Steve Kerr, the coach, do you like the strength in numbers, warm and fuzzy, everybody's involved, or do you like 50?
I just like winning. So whatever it takes. I think that's the beauty of Steph is he's so unselfish. 12 assists tonight. He's willing to do whatever it takes to win. I think he knew going into game 7 in Sacramento that he had to do what he did. And he doesn't have to take on that mentality every single night. Tonight he didn't. Got into the early foul trouble, but just the way things were clicking, I think Steph was very content just, being a more traditional point guard and, 20 assists or 20 points and 12 assists. That's a pretty good line for a point guard.
Steve, going back to JaMychal, can you explain a little bit more just why that he was the one you decided to put into the starting lineup? Because I know in the past when you've gone small, it's been with another guard like Jordan or Dante. So why was it JaMychal?
Lakers are huge. They're a massive team. And we felt like going into the game, we had to bring some size and physicality. So when we heard about Loon, we thought about, you know, different options, starting smaller. But we decided on JaMychal because we could still get the spacing with his three-point shooting ability, but we get a little more size and athleticism and some toughness, and we wanted to be more physical tonight, and he definitely brought that.
Teams have been defending your bigs like this for years, really. I mean, Sacramento, even in the first round, was obviously giving you guys a bunch of space. Do they do it more extreme than other teams?
The Lakers?
Yeah.
Yeah. Yeah, they did that in the regular season too. You know, they basically they'll pick certain guys and just, you know, not guard them and just pack the paint. So that's you know, and they're great. They're one of the best defensive teams in the league. So they know what they're doing, and they have a plan, and we, you know, we have to counter that.
It's part of that. You know, like Draymond was just kind of, you know, aggressive, straight lining to the rim at times. Is that part of it? Like, there just needs to be more emphasis on your big scoring?
Well, if we can get a little more spacing, then there's more lanes, more driving lanes for Draymond and for everybody else. So I think that's the, you know, that was the idea with JaMychal. It's just, you know, he's going to be out at the three-point line and you get a little more space, and Draymond was locked in from the beginning, wanted to be aggressive and had a little more room to attack.
Coach.
Last one.
Coach, when Jared Vanderbilt is guarding Steph, the angle of the screen seems like doesn't be working, especially when Steph is off the ball. Did you discuss this with your assistant coach, change these angles to have another option for Stephen?
When who's guarding Steph?
Jared Vanderbilt.
Vanderbilt?
Vanderbilt, yeah.
Yeah. Yeah, I mean, they're doing a really good job with Vanderbilt and Schroeder on Steph. They're both excellent defenders. They're kind of doing what we tried against Sacramento, to stay on top of the shooters. And it makes sense, you know. Obviously, our shooters between Steph and Klay and Jordan, you know, are really potent. So you try to take them off the three-point line, and then it's our job to try to figure out ways to free them up so they can get to the three-point line. And that's kind of the chess match that's going on.